G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. Have I got a cracker to show you today? Assault Models 116 Resin Kit 16013 German Machine Gunner 1943, all the way from Russia. Let's take a look. If you've seen my other videos, you know this is a real person, and they've gone and taken all the 1700 million photos of the person, you know, and standing in a circle all at once. And then, you know, then they've put it into a computer file, slapped it all together, and then 3D digitally printed it. And then here we have this lovely, real, lifelike man in resin, shrunken down. Now, straight off the bat, and I don't mean to be rude to the model who did this photo. And look, he's got a better head than I do. Don't worry about that. Absolutely got a better head than I do. But I don't know. The only thing that really probably, I think, a little bit of a different head. No offense, as I said to the guy who modeled it. Just a different head. I think I probably would have preferred someone maybe a bit more gaunt, maybe a little bit skinnier to maybe have his, I don't know. That's my only issue with this actual figure, as in pose-wise or anything like that. But other than that, absolutely love it. Let's have a look inside. Now, I have to say that given this was packed so well, posted to me, I was surprised when all of this just came like this, sort of in one, you know, bag, you know, because as you can see, and I don't know what they are, but there are a number of pieces that have either broken off in the process. I mean, I'm guessing the hand's broken off, but you can tell when you see a little, you know, resin thing like this, that crow, there's a crow outside that's just talking to me, guys. So I absolutely apologize about it. When you see, hang on, I'm going to go and talk to that crow. I wish I still had my my air rifle. That is so funny. As soon as I said air rifle, all those crows just shut up. That is hilarious. They must know me. But even this, I mean, that's a little bit bent, you know, and I don't know why. I mean, yeah, anyway, you know how Alpine does the boxes with the foam and does it all nice and neat. I think, you know, I love the box art, but I just think the Ziploc bag, when you're paying good money for this figure, it wasn't, you know, reasonably expensive, up getting up to nearly, I don't know, I'm not exaggerating, but it's probably up above the, getting closer to the $100 mark, I think, than the $50 mark, in Australian dollars, that is, especially when you're starting adding postage in. But, so, probably my first thing would be is, I think the Alpine thing with the foam or something a little bit nicer, especially to, you know, look after your little MG34 here. He's a little bit, you know, a little bit on the bent situation, a little bit. He's probably reasonably straight, but I think, you know, it would have been better if they'd probably packed it a little bit nicer. And as you can see, Assault Models, if you're looking, and maybe it was like this when you packed it, I don't know, but, you know, these little pieces broken off around the place. You know, maybe you're better off clipping it off yourself before you send it, or else it's just going to get broken off, which isn't a big deal if it's just on a little piece of uniform or something like that. But if it was on a piece of flesh, and it snapped off and broke some of the flesh off, well, that would be pretty annoying, having to putty up the flesh sort of thing. But anyway, we have a look at the main piece, the torso, the schmocky wocky. And look, you know, what is it? Was it the Andre figure I showed a while ago? You know, their 3D printed Fandangle thing, sort of the same thing. Look at this. This is an absolute cracker. Look at the creases on this. I mean, gets me excited. Look at that. Oh my goodness, guys. Seriously. I mean, even this gets me excited. You know, if you've been on my channel long enough, you know what I'm going to say. You know, the little locating, little tabs. I love this stuff in the new stuff and in the old stuff. The Warriors stuff used to do this. The S&T stuff did this. Look at this. How nice is this? How nice. Oh, look, you got a little groove over the top there for his little MG34 to sit in. I love when they, you know, years ago, you never got the straps for your rifles. You'd have a gun and, you know, you'd have to, you know, get the little piece of paper out or the lead foil or something to make your own little straps and stuff. And now look at this. You know, how good is it? How good is it? Oh my goodness, got someone talking outside, some of the builders, who knows, go and have a nice coffee and sausage roll, guys. Jeez, very nice texture on the boots. But I mean, look at the, I mean, you know, it's funny when I say this on these figures, look at the creases, you know, look at it, look at the, and I think, you know, that's amazingly sculpted, but this is sort of taken from a photograph. So, you know, I don't even know how I'm saying. These are real creases, if you know what I mean. They're not pretend made up, where would a crease be or where would a thing be. These are actually the real deal, if you know what I'm talking about. Look at the boots, even. You know, I mean, when you know you've got the real uniform, and there could be a little bit of casting line down there. Look at that. Look inside there, that little boot. I don't think that should be there. I don't know if that one should be there either. But, you know, when you're talking about the real uniform, taken with real photos of a real person in it, you know, it's very hard to get some little rivet counter to come in and start complaining about it. Because it's kind of real, apart from, you know, when it was taken. It wasn't taken in the, you know, 1940s. I thought that was full of magnets for a start. That was quite funny, isn't it? But, oh, I haven't done this before. This is the first time in doing this. And look at it. God, that looks like a magnet in there, doesn't it? No, it's not. But, God, I thought it was shiny there for a second. I thought, that looks like a magnet. But look at this. I love when this happens. If you're not a fan, which I'm definitely not, of sawing resin chunks and trying to putty up things to get them to fit and all that. I mean, obviously, we have to do that down this end. But look at that. I mean, that makes me so happy. Look at that. Look at it. There's no shush, builders. There is no putty to do there. That is, you know, if you like painting and you're not someone who's into scratch building, you'll be happy about that. But, you know, this is what I'm talking about. No offense to the model. I don't like, you know, I am an ugly little person. Looking wise, so no offense to this person because they look a lot more handsome than I do, but I just think for some reason, you know, I know everyone's got different shapes and faces and all that stuff, but to me, I think I probably would have liked someone who looked a little bit more gaunt, you know, a little bit skinnier in the face, maybe a little bit skinnier in the neck. Just, I think that was my only little thing with this figure properly, but just, we'll put it in, I mean, but oh, no, no, it didn't, guys. Holy dooly. This is starting to remind me of that. Was it the Andrea figure that I did in 1/16? Look at any of the John Rosengrant 1/9 German machine gunner. Look at that. So really, apart from a little bit of flash in there, probably the looks of it. Look underneath here with the little, you know, elasticy type bit for the camo. I don't know, it's just the face. He sort of reminds me of someone that, you know, I'd see working in an office behind a computer. And he might. But I don't know, it's just the face that just is. But other than that, you know, the sculpting, if it's a photo, 3D printed, the actual print out of this is amazing. Amazing. I might even see if one of the other Germo heads fits on this. That'd be interesting, wouldn't it? Wouldn't it? To see if the other ones fit on there from the other figures. So just quickly, this little arm, we'll check and see if this goes in too. It goes in there. Oh, yeah, look, I don't know. That does fit in there nicely. Don't get me wrong, it does. But, it's tough. I don't know if I'm a fan of that. I'm not as maybe, yeah, it's tough. It's tough. Sometimes, you know, I don't know if I'm a fan of that big. I just wonder if they could have done that, you know. I'm not a master 3D printer, cutter, or renderer, or anything like that, but I don't know. I'm guessing they've done that because, you know, the MG34 has to sort of come and sort of sit in there like that. So, yeah, that's interesting. All these pieces have actually just broken off. I haven't actually cut a piece off yet. They've all just broken off these things. But again, we've got this little arm here. And again, oh, look, you've got the little thing to putty up there, so you're going to have to put a little light. Oh, look at that little strap. There you go. There's the little strap. You're going to have to putty that up too a little bit. But, you know, that's all. I mean, oh, look, it's tough, isn't it? It's tough. You're getting such a nice printed, sculpted, whatever you want to call it, figure, as in the uniform, that, you know, something's got to give, doesn't it? But if it didn't have to give, I'd say I don't like these little joins here. I would have preferred the join, you know, around here, around the strap. I don't know. Maybe, you know, sometimes they have this whole piece that comes out and locks in. So then the actual join line is around the strap and the belt, you know, something like that. I don't know. Anyway, I'm sure these people have thought about this to no end, and they're looking at me going, you have no idea what you're talking about, buddy, which is fine. But, you know, I like to say what I think. You can see the little glove there on his hand and all the little creases in that. No veins in this one, guys. And, I mean, just look at... the rest of it, the little button there. And everything else, the little strap coming down the side there. Oh, man, you know. It is lovely. It is lovely. Here's a little water bottle here, and you can see the little texture on it, hopefully. It's funny, this water bottle, I don't know if I'm imagining it, or maybe the little bit's just not on it really tight, but it just seems to be on an angle, doesn't it? Which they probably, I'm guessing they've deliberately done, because I don't think that, because this is such one big chunk of resin, that I don't think it would have bent like that. So I'm guessing they've deliberately done that. And that sort of sits in this little piece like there. See that? They've got the little thing there. It sits in nicely. Look at the little thing they've got there. I really hope, Assault Models, if you're listening to me, which I doubt you are, but look at this piece here that they keep on pumping out, these 1/16th Germans. They are, I think that these are awesome. Absolutely awesome. I could even try an Alpine Miniatures head on one of these. I was just thinking to myself out loud, telling you guys. But, you know, look at this. Let's look at the straps. I love a good strap. The MG little kit, pouchy thingy, whatever it is. I've found out what this is so many times. And then, is it their cleaning kit or something? I can't remember, but I've found this out so many times and I just keep on forgetting. So I apologize. Write it down in the comments for me, guys. Tell me what this thing is again. And while you're there, what is this little one? Is that a little first aid kit on the top there of that little gas canister thing? Or what's this little thing for? Someone tell me this. I love asking comments now because I have three people that watch my videos and someone always normally gets back to me and says, that's what this is, which I absolutely love. This is a very nice rendition. Is it rendition? Rendition, I think it is. Of a MG34. And it's cast extremely well. There is a very minor seam line running down the bottom of it, but very cleanly done. It's not a nightmare of a seam line, but up the top, very impressed by this little fella. And you've got the little end. Sorry, it's out of focus, but, you know, a little bit cleared out there. And the holes are, you know, deep enough. And all the other little add-on bits. You know, sometimes you get a photo etch or brass or whatever. You know, barrel for an MG34, but then you've got to try and add all these other little bits onto it, which I'm just not interested in doing, guys. Too much mucking around. So this is really nice. They should sell these as a separate item. That'd be a smart idea. Very smart. Cannot complain, and apart from the little packaging of it being a bit bent, complain about that. Little bipod there. And again, the good thing about these 3D printed things is when they start getting really small, a lot of these things just seem to keep the detail so much better or come out so much better than, I don't know, sculpting. But then again, you know, as I've said, I think Reedy's Miniatures does some really nice weapons too. And I'm going to have to keep buying some of those because they're nice too. I'm going to settle down a bit and just say all up, I think that this is a very nice figure. The way it goes together, apart from the arm joins, which I'm not a huge fan of, I think it's a really nice kit. I definitely don't think you're going to be disappointed picking this kit up. A little bit more expensive, or, you know, getting up there in the 1/16 scale site, pricey type things. But, you know, I mean, you can't argue with the creases, the folds, the pose. You know, it's going to be, I think this brand, if they keep on doing 1/16 Germans, I think they're going to do very well for themselves. That's just my opinion. And especially when they're doing them 1/35 scale as well. I mean, they do this guy in 1/35 scale as well. So that's even more exciting if they bring this detail to the 1/35 scale one. And I will be reviewing that as well. As always, guys, thank you very much for watching. And I'll catch you later.